how do you imagine your essay and the kind of growth constraints that it might place as figuring into LA's overall strategy in terms of how it grows up?
It's going to be irrelevant because it only applies for, what, 2 years?
That's a moratorium, right?
And, but it gives a thing that the people in the various communities can have some say in how many tall buildings and more automobiles are going to be in their community. And I think we have to wake up to that. I mean, you have all of the SRO buildings have been torn down, and you have these fancy condominium buildings put up in their place, and it's become a very, very different city.
Where are you
going? I'm opposed to it. I mean, look, when people talk about, you know, building our transportation system, and, you know, where I came, you know, we came up with the notion, I said, it wasn't just about moving people, it was about reimagining this town. The fact is we have gridlock. That's not gonna change. The notion of great cities have density along transportation lines. That's just a fact. Every, you know, there's a lot of smart people here. We've got the history department, but if you can talk to every urban planner, every architect, and anyone that knows anything about great cities, they'll tell you, that's what smart growth is. We were the quintessential city of sprawl. We created jobs in the center core and all the housing in the outer core. That was a recipe for disaster. We see it every single day. So, you know, from my vantage point, making it more difficult in this town, you know, a town, you know, before I became mayor with 12 different departments to develop, takes years to develop anything. I lived in New York for 2 years after I left the mayor. They're building everywhere in New York. You go to Miami, you go to Chicago, yes. You know, you go to Seattle, you go to San Francisco. We gotta make smart investments. And so the notion that we're not gonna do that, just it riles me, everybody, because we've got a lot of people here. If we made it easier for, you spoke to affordable housing, we don't have affordable housing here. This is the least affordable big city. We should be leveraging all of that for affordability, for density bonuses that allow people to have smaller units and for us to address homelessness and a number of things. I don't buy the idea that it's too easy to develop in this town. It actually is very difficult. I heard, you know, for 8 years, and I know they probably did as well, just how difficult it is. I saw New York, it's a great place. You get on transportation, people live and work, you know, around transit stations. That's what we ought to do here. And that's what we are going to do here.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I live in Brentwood, and the time it takes for me to get to the 405 freeway from my house goes up about 5% a year. And if you take right now, it's like an hour and a half from my house on Sunset to 405. You take up that you have the Crusoe putting all those developments in Pacific Palisade, that's just going to add more and more cars. And is that good? How long does it take to get downtown from LA to go to the theater at night?
Oh, when you finish the subway, it'll take like 25 minutes. If we go to the line from Van Nuys under the freeway,
that's not
going to solve the whole problem, but neither is just standing still. That's not going to solve the whole problem either.
Mayor Hahn, I'm not sure.
I can't take a position. I'd just like to tell a little history, since this is a history school. My dad was a big history buff, and
a big supporter of the
alumni. But you know why? Because in April 1962, took my sister Janice and I and our mom to ride the red car, the last day it ran, from downtown to Long Beach. And remember what he said, Jim, we have a perfectly good urban railroad here in Los Angeles, but we're throwing it away. He said, but mark my words, one day we'll have to build it back.
Mm-hmm.
foot became the Blue Line, the first light rail line built here. We're now building more. I enjoy taking the Expo line, thanks to Mayor Villaraigosa and others who got that built from Santa Monica all the way to downtown. That's the way to go, Dick. Don't take your car.